Continuing now with the pair's figure skating competition.
We're back at the Olympic Ice Hall in Albertville. The pair's competition, one pair yet to skate, Brasseur and Eisler of Canada. They are in third place. Is there room for them at the top?
Absolutely. If you look at the marks there, 5.7s on the top mark for Mishkuchanok and Dmitriev leaves a lot of room for Brasseur and Eisler. The technical mark is their strength. The artistic mark breaks the tie. What they have to do is skate clean and get 8s and 9s on that technical mark, and they could pull it off.
Second in the world the last 2 years. Third after the original program from Canada, Isabelle Brasseur and Lloyd Eisler.
Differ from the Russian pairs because they're more technical skaters. Their focus is on the athleticism. There's lots of room, lots of marks left, but they've got to skate clean. Split triple twist, and it's huge! Throw triple toe loop, and she can't hang on to the landing. Now it's a battle for second place. Is the one Isabelle struggled with in the original program, and she does it! Mistakes from the Czechoslovakians and the other Russian pair. If they skate clean from now on, they'll definitely be on the podium. But the quality of everything they do from now on will dictate the color of the medal. One-handed starlift that takes so much strength and timing. Move, throw triple salchow, little 2 foot on the landing. A unique variation on a death spiral, an outside death spiral, changing over to the other foot to an inside death spiral. Something very difficult here. Double axel, and she cannot hang on to the landing. It must be fatigue.
Fatigue, and you also know that you've two-footed two of your major throws. Isabelle is a strong jumper. She just had trouble in the original program, and once your confidence is shaken, it's really hard to win it back.
And I think that is particularly the case for Isabelle Brasseur. She told us in a profile on these two that ran the other night, she had taken the psychological exam several times, and doggone it every time, she measured low in self-esteem. But it tells you everything you want to know about Isabelle Brasseur, that her nickname, given her by her partner, is Fred. And she smiles when you call her that. Of course, it tells you everything you want to know about Lloyd Eisler, that his nickname is Herbie, and he's got four tattoos.
Keep him on the podium.
Second or third?
Most likely third.
Lloyd and Isabelle, or Herbie and Fred? From Canada.
Look at their opening split triple twist. This thing is so big. Look how far above his head she gets. Spins three times around. Makes it look effortless.
Sorry,
and then a look at the throw triple toe. She just got a little back on her skates here, tilted backwards, and there was no way she could hang on to the landing. These are throws that they've been doing every day in practice.
Jose Picard, their coach, on the right side.
Sorry, Jose.
Isabelle Brasseur and her partner Lloyd Eisler are waiting for the first set of marks. And here they come.
And these marks really represent their strength, but they really didn't deliver as well as they had all week in practice. You have to think that the fall in the original program by Isabelle really affected her confidence. Another look at what makes them so terrific. Look at this one-arm star lift. Do you know how strong you have to be to do this? He's going about jogging speed. He lifts her with one hand, and she holds a beautiful air position.
And the second set of marks.
And these go up. Now, again, their strength is their technical and athletic ability. Their second mark goes up. That means the judge is really focused in on the mistakes that they made athletically.
And it means that Brasseur and Eisler, with aspirations for gold when they came to France, will have to settle for bronze. The gold medalists, the favorites, Miskuchanok and Dmitriev, so rewarded by every one of the nine judges. They were placed first by all nine. And the second place winners, the silver medalists, Bechki and Petrov,